Hey guys, what's up? I'm Chase from Money Matters, and in today's video, we will be breaking down how much Queen's Gambit main actors made from the lowest paid to the highest paid. Queen's Gambit is a drama miniseries that lingers on the topic of addiction and, for a sport, chess. It has become one of the biggest miniseries to ever hit the Netflix streaming service, with over 62 million households watching the series within the first month of its premiere. Let's take a look at the breakdown of earnings from the lowest paid to the highest paid actor. Thomas Brody, $2 million. To start us off with the list, as the actor with the lowest net worth from this series is Thomas Brody. He plays Benny Watts, who is Beth's fellow chess player, rival, and potential love interest in the series. He appeared in notable films as a child star, such as Love Actually, and has also most recently starred in films such as Nowhere Boy, Maze Runner, and Game of Thrones. Thomas Brody has an estimated net worth of $2 million. Harry Melling, $3 million. Next on the list is Harry Melling, who plays the role of Harry Beltic on the series. He comes into Beth's life when she is at such a low point and is also left in awe of her talent. Other than Queen's Gambit, Harry Melling is well known for his role as Dudley Dursley in the Harry Potter series. His other infamous roles are Just William, Robert Brown in 2010, and George Pinnock in Garrow's Law. He has also appeared in several stage productions such as Mother Courage and Her Children, The Hot House, and Woman Beware Woman. Harry Melling has an estimated net worth of $3 million. Anya Taylor, $3 million. Next on the list is Anya Taylor, who plays the lead role of Beth Harmon in this series. Beth is a young girl who was abandoned at a Kentucky orphanage after her mother tragically passed on. In the orphanage, Beth is taught how to play chess by one of the building's custodians. Other than Queen's Gambit, Anya Taylor is known for her critically acclaimed performance in the horror film The Witch. She has also been cast in films like Morgan, New Mutants, Split, Barack Obama biopic, Barry, and dramas like Peaky Blinders and The Miniaturist. All in all, she has been in the movie industry for several years, and her performance in Queen's Gambit made her a household name. Anya Taylor has an estimated net worth of $3 million. Marielle Heller, $5 million. The actress with the highest net worth from this series is Marielle Heller, who plays the role of Alma Wheatley. Alma is a lonely housewife with an absent husband who welcomes Beth into her home as her adopted daughter and much-needed companion. Other than her role in Queen's Gambit, Marielle Heller is also an American writer and director. She made her first appearance on TV in the film White People and has since then appeared in movies like Paper Anchor, A Walk Among the Tombstones, and MacGruber. She wrote and directed the film The Diary of a Teenage Girl in 2015 and has also directed and executive produced the 2020 movie called What the Constitution Means to Me. Overall, Marielle Heller has an estimated net worth of $5 million. Which actors from your favorite series would you like us to review next? Leave your answer in the comments section below. Whose income would you love us to dig into next? If you enjoyed watching this, like and subscribe for more videos. Thanks for watching.